Service Director here at Tom Edwards Chrysler Dodge. I am sure there are those of you, when driving into a service department, ask the question, what is maintenance and what do I check for? Well, we at the Tom Edwards Chrysler Dodge Service Department have developed for you a series of short video episodes that will hopefully answer these important questions. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the episode.
When you are going to get your vehicle serviced, there are questions that vehicle owners will ask themselves, such as, what is an appropriate service interval, and what other items should be taken care of at my service visit? At our dealership, you will be greeted by a friendly, professional service lane rider who will assist and guide you in your entire service experience. In this episode, we will overview checking your oil, and when to have it changed, the air filter, where to find it, how to check its condition, and how to know when it's in need of being replaced. We will show you how to read and understand the condition, depth, and overall wear of your tires, in addition to also showing you how to check tire inflation and how to properly set the correct air pressures. The first thing we will discuss is checking the oil, which will include opening the hood, removing the dipstick, checking the fluid level and condition, reinserting the dipstick, and knowing what kind of oil to use. The first step in opening the hood is finding the hood latch release lever. It is normally located on the driver's side underneath the dash. Simply pull the release lever till you hear or feel the hood release. Then go around to the front of the vehicle and find the secondary release lever. It is normally located underneath the hood in the center of the grill. Simply push or pull the second release lever to obtain access to the engine bay area. The engine oil dipstick is located around or near the engine area and is recognized by its yellow handle and has written on it engine. The first removal of the engine oil dipstick is not the reading you should use, as it is not a true engine oil level. Simply clean off the end of the dipstick and reinsert it into the dipstick hole. The second removal of the dipstick is the reading that you should use. If you look on the end of the dipstick, there is markings for a high and low fill. It is between these two areas that your engine should have the appropriate fill of oil. In examining the oil, you want to look for dirt particles or a dark colored look in the oil. If you see either one of these, you should probably want to get the oil changed. If you notice, however, a milky substance, you should address this issue immediately with your service department. The engine oil cap is marked with the minimum engine oil rating that should be used for your automobile. If you want to use a higher rating, that is fine, but you should never use less than the minimum engine oil rating. In the next section, we will overview the air filter. We will discuss where it is located, checking its condition, knowing when it's needing to be replaced, and the overall advantage of having a clean air filter. The air filter is located in the air filter box. To gain access to the air filter, the loosening or removal of some hardware may be necessary. The top of the air filter box will need to be removed next. It is held down by either clips or fastening bolts. Once the clips or bolts have been removed, simply slide the retaining teeth in the appropriate direction and remove the top of the air filter box. To remove the air filter, simply grab the edges and remove it from the air box. When inspecting the air filter, you want to hold it up to a bright light source and inspect the pleats for any clogging from dirt or other particles. This is an example of a dirty air filter. It has a yellow discoloration, there are oil residue spots, and the pleats are clogged with dirt, preventing clean cold air from getting to the engine. This clean air filter, as you notice, has a nice white color. No oil residue, and the pleats are free from debris. To reinstall the air filter, simply place it back into the airbox. Then reinstall the top of the airbox in the reverse process from when you removed it. You want to ensure that there is a good clean seal around the air filter. You can inspect this by looking at the top of the airbox and noticing if there is any excess hangover of the air filter protruding from the airbox. The reason you want to ensure there is a good clean seal is that if there is not, this will allow for hot air or dirt to enter into the engine, causing poor engine performance. You also want to refasten or install the hardware you removed to take off the top of the air box. The biggest benefit to having a clean air filter is any time you can provide cooler, cleaner air to the engine, it will result in improved fuel mileage. In the last section, we will be discussing checking the tires. We will overview how to interpret the condition, wear patterns, and tread depth. Also, how to properly check and set the tire air pressure. When checking the condition and wear of your tires, you will want to run your hand across the top and sides of the tire, checking for bumps or flat spots in the tire. If you find either one of these, you should want to have your tires rotated and balanced. The tread depth of a tire is measured in 32nds of an inch. Anything from 6/32 and higher is a good tire. Anything from 4 to 5/32 is when you should want to think about replacing your tires. Anything below 4/32, you should want to replace immediately, as there is a potential for safety and road hazard to yourself and your vehicle, and could cause a potential accident. When checking the air pressure, you should use a proper functioning air gauge. First, remove the valve stem cap. Then put on the air pressure gauge, making sure there is no air leaking out from the gauge. If there is air leaking out, this is not an accurate reading of the air pressure. Most passenger cars and vehicles should have the air pressures set from 32 to 36 pounds of pressure when cold. Anything less than 32, and you should inflate the tire back to the appropriate range. The maximum air pressure will vary from manufacturers and will differ from different tire sizes.
Welcome back. I hope the video today helped answer some important questions pertaining to the maintenance and upkeep of your automobile. If you have any further questions, please feel free to contact us through email at service@edwardschrysler.com, or you can find us on Facebook under Tom Edwards Chrysler Dodge, or on MySpace at www.myspace.com/yourchryslerdodgedealer, or at edwardschrysler.com, or feel free to call us at area code 863-533-0793 and just ask for the service department. Thank you for joining us today, and stay tuned as we will be bringing you more videos on the topic of what is maintenance and what do I check for. My name is Clint Edwards, and thanks for stopping by.